If you can decipher who the message is from and deliver it quietly, 'cause some don't get
the conspiracy on the planet is the conspiracy of the stupid, to prevent schools from educating their children because they want their children to be as dumb as they are, to prevent television from putting anything intelligent on as much as possible.
Psyche that seems to be drawn towards these conspiracy theories? Is it some love of the unknown, or some idea that there may be forces out there that are controlling our destiny?
Well, I think there are three factors. A, nobody likes to take the blame for their own problems, so they look for somebody else to blame. And if you can find a big enough group, you've explained everything in your life that doesn't work.
That's the parental conspiracy theory.
Yeah, it's not your fault. It's the fault. If it's not your fault, your fault are your parents. It's the Jesuits, the Freemasons, the Jews, the Bilderbergers, the Council. And the transmission of information is going faster and faster due to internet and the whole computer revolution, which means that most people are living in a world they can't understand. And when people can't understand something, they tend to go for sinister explanations of it. Somebody is manipulating things in a way I don't like. That's the way people feel when things change too fast and they can't understand it. And the third reason is, of course, that there are lots of conspiracies around. Lots of conspiracies around. There are lots of conspiracies around.
You have
just telling you what I found. I have found that at the very heart and core of all these secret societies lurks the Kabbalah. The Kabbalah is the ancient Jewish mysticism. It is a method of encoding information through a system of mathematics and numbers. It is some of the most ancient knowledge that man has ever possessed and has been kept secret and given only to those who have proven themselves worthy through the process of initiation. Nobody knows where it comes from. I can tell you this, it was there long before the Jews came along. The Jews just took it and preserved it, and they passed it down, and it's used by everybody. Because it's at the heart and core of the secret knowledge, the metaphysics, the real science that none of us know anything about. These people that belong to the secret societies never dared to write down in any language what they knew, what it was that they were guarding, because then someone could steal it and then the secret would be out. So they devised secret systems of encoding the secrets of the ages, the knowledge, the hidden knowledge, the occult. Now, occult doesn't mean evil. It doesn't mean the devil. It doesn't mean Satan. Occult means hidden. It means hidden. That's all it means. So they took this knowledge and they made it occult through a system of encoding, encryption, one of which is mathematics, numbers. Another is architecture. Everybody wonder, why do they have a fraternal organization called the Freemasons? Aren't those the guys that build walls? You bet they do. But every wall they build contains the secrets that have been kept and maintained throughout the ages, and it's encoded in the architecture and in the measurements of the buildings and in the mathematical formulas used to derive the geometry, the shape, the length and breadth and height of rooms. It's all encoded there.